So my name's Stuart Davies. I'm the director of the Center for Tropical Forest Science, also known as the Forest Global Earth Observatory. We're doing long-term research on how forests work at a global scale.
My name is Helena Miller-Landau. I'm a staff scientist at the Smithsonian Tropical Research Institute, working with the CTFS-ForestGEO network, also known as CTFS. I coordinate the carbon research program across the plot network.
My name is David Kenfag. I'm originally from Cameroon. I coordinate the network of large census plot in Africa.
I'm Sean McMahon. I'm the temperate program coordinator for the network.
My name is Peter Umunai.
I'm Zhiming Jiang.
My name is Mohiza Mohammed.
My name is Rebecca Ostertag.
Mi nombre es Alvaro Uke.
I'm Liza Kamita.
My name is Joe Wright. I've been associated with the CTFS, the Center for Tropical Forest Science, before it had that name, before there was a center, just a single plot.
One very important thing to recognize is that we started off, this whole initiative started off through Steve Hubble, Robin Foster, Peter Ashton, with an idea about how to do science in tropical forests.
Prior to the 50-hectare plot being established on BCI, the standard procedure was a 1-hectare plot with only the trees larger than 10 centimeters, about 4 inches in diameter, being mapped. And people would attempt to identify them all to species. And their understanding of the forest was coming from this sample.
Interesting, the limitation of that, of course, when you look at it, so 100 1-hectare plots is 1 square kilometer. The Amazon is several million square kilometers. So we're literally talking about a 1 in a million sample when we're trying to, as a basis for extrapolation, which of course is always a bit dangerous, to say the least.
So Steve Hubble was always thinking big, and he figured what one had to do was increase the sample by orders of magnitude.
And so what Steve and Robin Foster did back in 1980 is they went to Ira Rubinoff, then director of STRI, and said, hey, look, you know, we want to set up a plot of 50 hectares, an area where we want to map and measure every single stem.
Down to 1 centimeter diameter. That is, you know, the size of my thumb.
In order to understand how diversity is distributed in space, and then we're going to monitor it through time so we can understand how it's changing through time.
So the 50 hectare plot is 50 times larger in area. But even more important, instead of limiting it to trees 10 centimeters, he went down to 1/10 of that. Instead of having 500 or 600 individuals, he had 250,000.
Todos se mapean, se miden, se muestra, se toma una muestra botánica para hacer una identificación de la especie, y se someten de ahí en adelante a un monitoreo continuo.
One plot with data like that allows us to look into a lot of things about that forest, its productivity, biomass, dynamics.
The cool thing about having CTFS as a network is that it's scientists that are using the exact same methodology across the globe.
And that then gives us a whole additional higher level of questions we can look at.
You can compare a Hawaiian forest that might have similar latitude to the Puerto Rico plots or the Taiwan plots, for example.
El Nino is happening here in Panama. It's also going to affect the plots in California, you know, Yosemite and California. It's also going to affect the Southeast Asian plots. So we're basically able to tie together kind of global dynamics.
Understanding the dynamics of forests, how forests grow, how healthy forests are, is really important globally because forests contain a huge amount of the biodiversity in the world, more important for sequestering carbon. There's a reason why we love forests and studying forests. They're beautiful, wonderful places to be.
We recognize, and many people recognize, that the future of tropical forests depends on the countries in which these tropical forests exist. Places like Panama, Malaysia, Cameroon.
People tend to cut down the trees and the forest to make way for development.
We can tell them that, okay, you are cutting this tree, but just know that the next one to get to the size that you'll be able to explore will take this many years.
If there's less of research in the forest and about the forest, it's like the policymakers doesn't know the function of the forest.
Well, this work has been used a lot to inform decision makers, right? Because now that the country is committed to REDD+, which is reducing emissions from deforestation and forest degradation and forest conservation, they use the Ituri data to predict how much biomass they will get, because that will be traded in carbon market.
You know, we are in an era of change. You know, there is climate change, and what our plot do is, our plot are like a laboratory where we capture all the effects of unexpected events.
And it happens around the globe. We don't have much time, actually, because the environment changed so fast. Given this limited time, we have to understand our system better in order to cope with the future change.
And in a way, we're just catching up to understanding that. I mean, we're tasked right now as forest ecologists with both predicting the future and trying to understand the present at the same time.
Every challenge brings opportunities. One of the very interesting things about the network is that it does bring together people from very different countries and cultures and scientific traditions or local academic traditions.
It creates opportunities for each of these individuals to learn new things, to understand different cultures, to understand different forests. So it's really a pretty exciting enterprise.
So what is ForestGEO? I think at its core it's a relatively simple but extremely powerful idea, which is that if you measure trees in the same way at every site, then you have identical data that you can compare across sites.
If the idea was a bad idea, I think it would have failed very early on. But people realized, I mean, the research community realized, well, this is an interesting way to look at forests. And I want to replicate that in my forest to understand how it fits into the global picture.